for the GMs and the managers out there, what do you say some of those identifiers are within their staff that is just like, hey, man, something's not right here. I need to have a conversation with them.
Yeah, so I think it's actually further than that. And I think if you get to that point where you start to identify it's time for a conversation, I think you've failed as a leader.
Good point.
So our role as the leader right now is to maximize our communication levels and become the one thing in our people that we have the blessing of leading. We have to become the one area that is stable, the one area that is safe, right? Because when they go home, we can't control what's happening at home. We don't know what their spouses are doing. We don't know what their kids are into. We don't, you know, we can talk to them about those things, but we can't necessarily understand and step into their shoes.
For sure.
So what we have to do as leaders in the auto industry and in industry as whole is we have to increase the communication to a massive level. We have to over communicate about every little thing, right? We have to have a daily meeting at the same time every single day. We have to have Zoom check-ins with people that aren't necessarily working on site and make sure they still feel like they're involved and part of the team. We have to do things on a structure and a schedule because they might not know, you know, what's going on tomorrow and whether or not they're going to be able to go to a restaurant, go to a gym, or take their kids to school. But they need to know that they have a meeting at 9 o'clock with you where they're going to be seen, they're going to be held accountable, and they're going to be held responsible. And they're also going to have an opportunity to express any concerns or any worries, and that there's going to be an ear there on the other side that is not necessarily going to say, I understand, but is going to say, hey, it's okay for you to feel right now.